Welcome back to Neverwinter Nights 2 Hard Mode Edition. Let's continue. Okay. Do you know anything about what happened in Ember? Haven't heard much more than the rumors, though. The idiot Ergon claims to have been there, even for the attackers to say. Who's Ergon? Port last resident Braggett he is, always boasting of deeds done in Dragon Slain, mind you. No one has ever seen him do anything but talk. Men can't handle a butter knife, much less a stout blade. Took pity and tried to teach him a few tricks, but he was hopeless. A braggart, eh? We're off men telling wild tales. If lies and respect enough times, people will believe them. We may wish to find Ergon and make sure he's not telling stories about Ember. Okay.
Yes.
Up here. Short sound. +3. Yeah, short sword +2. So let's see if we can find a better one.
I concur.
I think I can buy some of this. I don't have enough money.
Yes. Something you want?
I concur.
Yeah.
Well now, what do you want?
Let's see. Need more money. Let's see what he has for sale. Ice dagger. see what he has for sale.
Yeah.
So the laser
Step
plus
with me.
Three.
Come on. Follow along.
Breastplate. Armor of loyalty. Full plate.
Yes.
What Chandra has. Okay. Let's continue.
Follow along.
I'm surprised you have the courage to show your face here. A lot of people here had friends in Ember. If they find out who you are.
I'm not responsible for what happened, and I'm here to clear my name.
You're free to conduct your business here, but you'll be watched. If you have questions, ask them now. I'm a busy man.
What do you know of Black Garius?
A Luskan Archmage of some power. Not someone you want to cross. Like many of the Arcane Brotherhood, Black Garius aspires to rule, regardless of what harm it may cause.
I think you will find that attitude common among most of the Hostower, and Garius in particular.
What worries me is that he may succeed.
Why do you say that?
He's amassing power at a pace I dislike. I suspect his brothers are beginning to grow wary of him.
Makes you think so.
Followers flock to his side like vultures to a battlefield. Two in particular keep me awake at night.
Which two?
The woman Torio Claven and that giant Lorne.
Ah, and so the pretty little circle reveals itself.
Torio, you might know as Luskan's ambassador to Neverwinter. A treacherous snake, that one. The other one, Lorne, lacks Torio's guile, but compensates for it with brute force. He's a savage fighter and extremely good with a blade. I suspect he handles most of Garius's dirty work.
What happened to Tendo?
Innocents slaughtered. The village burned to the ground. All done by you. My only regret is that Ember falls under Luskan jurisdiction, not mine.
I saw certain it was me.
There was a witness to the attack. You were described in great detail.
I would like to speak to the witness.
Out of the question. She's been through enough. And besides, you won't like what she has to say.
Diplomacy. I need to speak with all witnesses, no matter what they may say about me.
Very well. You may question the witness, but you shall do it in my presence. Bring the girl here.
Yes, Captain.
Chandra? Chandra, is that you? Elaine, you survived. Thank the gods. Chandra, it was horrible. They butchered everyone. Elaine, it's all right. Shh. Look, I brought people to help. We'll get to the bottom of this. You! Chandra, it's him! Why would you bring him here?
I'm not responsible for what happened at Ember.
I saw you murder those people. No, Elaine, it's not true. I know what I saw. They had no weapons. Some even surrendered. But he...
We're here to help you, not hurt you.
That's right, Elaine. We're here to help, all right? It was trade season, and the shipments into Ember had fallen off. I had decided to trade along the south roads. When I came back to Ember, I heard the screams and saw the smoke. I left my wagon and went into town. That's when I saw the bodies. I saw him kill the quartermaster while he was on his knees, begging for his life.
You saw this man here do the killing blow? And was it just him? And where did he...
Sand!
We don't have all year, girl. Nor do I have the patience when the trail of these killers grows colder.
There were others, but I didn't see them closely. I ran as hard as I could to Port Last, and they took me in.
But you did do it.
Or someone that looked the part. There are many magics that can cloak one's appearance, even allow one to change shape.
I know what I saw.
Diplomacy. Don't you think it's possible that it was someone else disguised as me?
I suppose it's possible, but I don't know. I just don't know.
How did you manage to get away if I get close enough to identify me?
I don't know. I just started running. I guess they didn't notice me.
You were lucky, Or perhaps they let you escape.
Where's all beside me? Were any of my companions there?
You had about a dozen of your friends with you. But I don't recognize anyone with you now.
A dozen, you say? Interesting. Do go on.
So did you see a dwarf, a gnome, a half-demon girl?
Well, no. I believe they were all human.
Well, considering that those two and the gnome account for at least half of us, that might seed some doubt.
But you could have just hired others.
Yes, my dear. But as your hesitation suggests, why would anyone do that when they have trusted allies who would follow one anywhere, despite their common sense? No offense.
That's all I need to know. Thanks for helping.
I'm sorry to have put you through this, Elaine. Guard, please see that she reaches her quarters safely.
Listen to me. If we can get her to work for us, her story of tears will sway the court in our favor.
Elaine's not some tool, Sand. She's just survived the massacre of her town, which someone caused to get to us.
Girl, if we do not use your friend, the Luskins will, and they will use her testimony to kill our friend here. So, please dispense with your convenient morality. Either we use her, or they do.
She's been through enough, and I don't want to make her a target.
Good. Glad to hear someone here is making some sense. Leave her alone, Sand. I mean it.
Forget it, then. I can't help this matter if you won't heed my counsel. Maybe you will when you're hanging from the gallows, twisting in the wind.
Again, friends with Chandra, last with Sand.
I concur.
Shadow Shield and more Dickens sword.
You before me.
What can you tell me about Portlast?
I'm no common magistrate with idle time to... I'll be happy to discuss the finer points of Portlast with you when you're no longer a suspected mass murderer.
Do I worry you?
No. I have more important things to worry about.
Luskan is a threat to you, isn't it?
Of course. The Luskans would lay claim to our harbor for the... Having secured such a prominent location, they could mount a swift attack on Neverwinter. Or Waterdeep, for that matter. They talk of a peaceful coexistence, but I know their words to... Luskans' difficulties with Ruithim may have come at a fortunate time. As long as Luskan is at war with their island neighbor, they cannot turn their attention elsewhere.
Okay. Chandra gained 11.
Yes.
Okay.
I believe so.
Oh, the almighty Wendesnaven. The Wendesnaven, yes. What the in the nine hells are you talking about? The Wendesnaven see all, but none can see them. I see, they see. Yes, but who are the Wendesnaven? The Wendesnaven know all, but none of them. Yes, you know. No, oh. I don't think you two both are clearly insane. Sounds like they're talking nonsense, but there's a strange reason to it. It's like listening to a drunk worm now. Next time we can bring him and he can try to listen. Okay, let's talk to Nia. Careful there. Watch the worm mage. Worm's sage. I ought to tidy up, but there's never time. Worm sage, isn't that a agent for preventing undeath? Yes, that's right. You have an eye for the upskill. Does Portlast have any undead problem? No, it's Ember, a little village north of here. The people were slaughtered horribly. If their bodies aren't tended, they return as undead. It's only a matter of time. I've not been to Ember since the massacre, but I've heard that the bodies are rotting where they are. What's the thing? Why haven't the bodies been buried? Ember is in Laskan territory, and the Laskans haven't bothered. Not that I expect anything less from Laskan. Surely you can see that. It's a crime. Those corpses mustn't be left to rot, or nor should innocent souls be condemned to torture. Perhaps you could help. You seem hard to sort. Alright, what do you need me to do? I knew you would understand. Look here, this is a one sage extract, mixed with some other regrain. You need only sprinkle the bodies with this extract. If the souls remain trapped within, the negative energy will be suppressed, and they will be free to pass beyond this world. An overly dramatic description and assumption of the properties of souls, but she is correct. The worm says will serve to fight necromantic art. Here, take this bag, sprinkle a pinch of powder over each corpse you find, and that would enough to put to rest. I'm waiting for your return. Show me what you have for sale. Belt of Agility. Boots of the Sun Soul. I got better boots. Greater Magic. Wow, very nice ring. Let's buy it for sand.
Listening, really.
Now we have a lot of spells. Burning hands. And let's mirror image. Looks 10. this one. And level 4 spend. Let's have this one.
Well now, what do you...
I think it is time everyone marched behind
me,
your new glorious
Follow along.
Leader.
User, stop right where you are. Is there a problem? The problem is that you massacred the people of Ember. And don't let matters run loose in Portlas. Like I said to numerous other people, I'm not responsible for what happened. You forgive us if you don't believe a word that comes out of your mouth. We're going to arrest you for disturbing the peace. You're going to become violent and regretfully will be forced to kill you. Diplomacy. You're a guard charged with protecting Portlas, correct? An honorable position, if I'm not mistaken. You're damn right it is. What's your point? It's also your duty to meet justice of whatever you feel like it. What does it matter? Everybody needs justice. My guilt or innocence will be determined by the trial, not here, not by you. Alright, you can go. Don't think we won't be watching you though. Welcome to the Alliance Arm. What can I help you with? Can you tell me anything about what happened in November? I can tell you plenty, but whether any of it's the truth, whether the man has seen. What have you heard? Take this rumor for start. Some folks say it was the beast of the Duskwood, the savage Ember, revenge for disturbing their nests or some or such. Frankly, I'm inclined to believe that one. Portlas has a bit of werewolf problem. Not too long ago, wouldn't surprise me if there are more of them hanging about. Go on. There was this Sloskin woman sniffing around a while back. According to her, some adventurers stalled into her and slaughtered everyone for that was the chuckles. Nothing but lies come out of Sloskin lips, so you can ignore that one. That's just my opinion, though. And I understand, is Eldon? Then there's Ergon, one of my regulars. He claims he was there, saw the whole thing. I wouldn't exactly call him a liar, but he's always talking about adventures. Which conversely happened when no one else is around. Others and Ergon, you don't know anyone else who saw what happened? Well, Hermon seems to have a guest staying with him nowadays, with guards and all. Could be one of the attackers, more likely a survivor. Where can I find Ergon? Head over to the common room, probably telling the story of the 100th time. I had just lined up my arrow on the deer when I heard a growl. I turned, and there was the biggest, blackest wolf I had ever seen coming right at me. Luckily for me, I had an enchanted dagger with me. With his jaws only inches away from my throat, I lunged, and with a quick twist of the blade, I cut out the beast's heart. Ooh! I was a bit tired after all that fun in the Duskwood, so I decided to head to an ember to rest up. That's when I smelled the smoke. I ran there quickly as I could. And what did I see? The village in flames, the defenseless people being slaughtered by a cruel and evil man. There was dozens of attackers, heavily armed, a creature, demons, I think. So what did you do? The only thing I could do, I attacked. I cut down two of them before they knew I was there. But the others, seeing what a threat I was, ganged up on me. I slew several before one of them snuck up from behind and knocked me unconscious. Their enemy must have been... fought me dead, because when I woke they were gone. Yet hardly a scratch on him, a tale would tell well worth its weight in words, no doubt. And what of Ember? Sadly I was too late, everyone was dead. There was little more I could do, so I returned to Portlas. At least you tried, Ergon. This man is clearly a fool, but it is his audience that concerns me. Such tales could be used against us. We should question Ergon and see what Hello there, what are you right? I don't think I've seen a gnome like you before. You're not sick or something, you know? I spoke with Survivor, right? There was only about a dozen attackers in Ember, and nothing was mentioned about demons. Survivor? Well, that's a good news. Before the smoke, I'm sure I could have been mistaken. Tricks on the eyes and all that. It's full of crap. Now, if you'll excuse me. I just said you can barely handle blade, yet you managed to kill many of those attackers. What is wrong? I didn't need his training. I learned to fight somewhere else. Now you excuse me, farewell for now. He's asleep around. Let's ask around town and see if anyone can help us shed some light on some of the more flamboyant statements. Let's talk about Ember. Did you see who led the attack on Ember? Regretfully, I didn't. Otherwise, it'd be... Okay. Many pardons, but I have a lot of my mind. Waiting for someone? My father, my partner, Bradbury, is 2 days late for a meeting. He's an orphan and a fool. But he's a good with a pick and wedge and has brought much silver to my house. I was planning on taking him to Am with me, but I had available. You two are miners? I'm an artisan and a master trader. Strength can be mined to coin, but it needs to fully utilize it. Until Bradbury returns, I cannot leave for Am, and I cannot find work in this place. This northern fox will not deal with a stranger. What Bradbury looks like? He's hard to miss. His hair is bright orange like a flame blooms in the desert. If that happens to see him, just tell him I'm still waiting. Ah, Marlin, still playing Girl of the Wood. Bishop, I was wondering when you'd drag your sorry carcass back to Portlas. You waited for me, I'm touched. Then again, it's not like you could have tracked me down if you wanted to. I take it you two know each other. You could say that, liking him is another matter, however. This half-elf slip of a girl, you nearly got me. And herself killed several times over. Was caught in the Alaskan border. Impatience, incompetences, things get scouts killed. That's the trouble when you're not fully an elf, not fully human. It's like you always got something to prove. Watch it, there's no need to be insulting. An insult is an insult in a simple fact, but perhaps you are nothing true. What's your business, Portlas? I'm investigating the murders in Ember. What's to investigate? The village is destroyed and everyone's dead. Could have been brigands or gods to know what else, but Lord Justice will bring those villagers back. Do you know anything when we witnessed the attack on Ember? Maybe. 3 days gone, I was passing just south of Duskwood when I spied a column of smoke at sight coming from the village that's above Duskwood Grove. Could have been some traveler stepping for the night, or could have been someone else made home for himself. There's a cave up there in a good spot of a camp. Either way, the grove is an hour's walk from Ember, maybe less. Whoever up there may have been to see what happened in the village. How do you know Bishop? Oh, this could be rich. Go on, Marlin, tell him. Not while he's here. I can barely stomach the smell as it is. If you don't want to know, ask him when he's not around. What brings you to Port Lask? I'm fresh from Duskwood Grove, took a wound for a dire bone and the beast gave chase, otherwise... If you could tell me the place, depending on what you mean, I don't know much about Portlas, but I could bend your ear for hours about the land betwixt the Alaskan border. Mostly if it's Arcus Forest, they say the wood is magic properties. Me, I've cut down trees, around the dryads and those looking on. The only place of note is Duskwood Grove, but it's gone strange of late. Used to be deer here. There, and plenty for hunting. Now there's something driving all the deer away. Nothing but ferocious beasts and strangest things for miles around the grove. Wait, did Elgin say he was hunting deer when Ember was attacked? Unless he was hunting deer, that was a comely stranger of ferocious. I think the man of some explaining to do. Farewell.
I am listening.
Well,
Yeah? Something you need.
What happened with you and Marlene Potter?
All that goes on between a man and a woman. What do you think? I'm no noble to cloak it all up in pretty words and painted shields. After a while, though, you start to see the person, and if you don't respect them, then you leave. Simple as that.
Is that what you're going to do to me?
If I lose respect in you, you better believe it.
Back again, let's talk about Ember. You were hunting deer in the Duskwood. Marlin says there's no deer to be found there at all. I saw plenty, I don't know what you're talking about. Look, it's obvious you know I wasn't there. Why do you say you were there? Free ale and attention of women. Women, of course. You think someone like me could get that otherwise? Tell me what actually happened. I've heard there was a dryad in the Duskwood, so I figured, well, you know how dryads are with men, I mean. Oh god, they're predictable. I think a dryad then will do more to get men lost in the wood than the dryad himself. I didn't get too far in before the wolves chased me away, so I decided to stop in Ember for a while. Then I saw the smoke for Ember, so I didn't dare to head that way. By the time I got back to Port Lass, people were already talking about the massacre. No one around here seems to know what really happened, so I figured I might as well embellish my involvement. No one's getting hurt, right? Lies serve no one. Someone may be harmed by the tales you're telling. Oh, please. All the harm's already been done. Everyone thinks you're a witness if Ember attackers hear about you. Oh no, I didn't even consider that. Oh, everyone's have an announcement. That should keep his mouth closed. We didn't need him spending any more of his white tails before the trial. Well done, let's move on. Nice. Now we should visit Ember. Finally. Let's go to Ember. It's efficient. Whoever did this, it took care of the secure perimeters first. Then move on. Look, you can tell from the position of the corpses. Wouldn't put it past Luskans. They usually don't bother trying to place blame as well. So they may have made mistakes. I was just traveling through the last season. There was a quartermaster house. In the lane's house, by the god, who could have done this? These villagers, none of them were soldiers. It would have been a massacre. My dear, it was a massacre. Come, let us see what we can find. Hold on a moment. I heard something moving in the well. I heard it too. It could be a survivor or one of the murderers. I think we can find out. Well met. We keep running into each other. There's definitely more than the luck of the world at work here. Unfortunately, it's likely our last meeting. Did you see what happened in the village? Unfortunately, no. I arrived after the senseless slaughter. What I can tell you is that it was not done by orcs or barbarians. I came here to explore the wonders of the Duskwood and found great tragedy instead. I've seen many things in my years, both wondrous and terrible, but seeing the fate of this town, I feel as these very many years escaped me and my journeys just come to an end. The only thing left to me is to find a warm fire to rest my bones inside, and perhaps some eager listening to hear what I've learned from the world. You will always have a place at my fire. You really mean that. I am very grateful, and I think we'll take you up on the offer soon. Your kind words have inspired me to make one last journey. When I'm done, I'll find you and share with you my knowledge of the road. It seems we have found a quartermaster log, a little charred but intact. Let's see. He sure did keep a lot of notes. It's not complicated to see. In fact, over the past few weeks, it doesn't look like many shipments actually came into Ember. Not even from Laskan, that's odd. Not if Laskan knew there wouldn't be reason to send shipments anymore. Which would mean they knew the village would be destroyed. Let's save this log book for the trial and see if we can explain their cautious foresight in the massacre. I think we should keep searching for more clues. There may be other items in Ember attackers missed in their haste. Look at this. We have another thing we need to do, son. This corpse is usually this color, much different from the usual decay. Good eyes, what does it mean, though? If that's scanned, that's doing my job. The sooner I put together these pieces, the sooner. These wounds are superficial, not deep enough to kill, and the scent copied with the discoloration of the skin here and here. This man died from poison, and an unusual one at that. You won't find it in any of the apothecaries or potion shops in Neverwinter, but it's local favorite among several of the less friendly assassin guilds in Luskan. I don't even know how you can tell that. Trust me, I've seen a lot of death over the centuries. Let me take a sample from the body. I think we'll serve as a valid piece of evidence. I think we should keep searching for more clues or maybe other items that Ember attackers missed. Let's go down the well. Climb down. I knew I'd see you again. And you're finally here. Are you alright? I'm hungry, but I'm okay. What happened to the village? Men came. When I saw them, I knew they were the ones who would kill everyone. There was no place for me to hide except in the well. I watched them kill all the people. I didn't want to, but it felt important for me to see what happened so I could tell you. What did these men look like? How many were there? There were 12 of them, I think. Had dark armor and none of them looked like you. I knew he wasn't though. And how did you know that? When I really focused on him, he started to look different. I saw a man who was big and mean, like an ogre, but bald. The testimony could prove useful. We should take him with us back to Neverwinter when we're done here. We've been down here all this time? Yes, I knew he would be coming here, so I waited. I'll take you to Portlas, you'll be safe now. I can make it on my own. Alright, but be careful. I'll wait you for the Alliance Army and flag over some extra food and place of that. Oh, and I almost forgot. Here's the knife you gave me. It helped me survive down here, but I won't need it anymore. About time it got back. Bye. Plus 2 dexterity. It's a good knife for Nishka. Look out, a gnome. Wake up, wake up. Stay back or we'll kill you. I'm not going to fight, but I will defend myself. We already killed one of the hunters today. You go away or we kill you too. Who was this other intruder? He was a human, very fast, with sharp weapons. He killed some of the tribe, but you kill him too. Glek, take his golden trophy, sleek, shiny, stones where his eyes used to be. You should find out more about this intruder. He could have been one of the ones who attacked Ember. Will you let me speak to Glek? Why intruder? What's your friend? Actually, maybe I've been an enemy. You wait here, you see what Glek wants to talk to you. Glek say you can come inside. You not think you're friend of the other intruder. But that means you can trust him. We're watching you closely. Glek. Ulip tell me you wish to know about the intruder who came to our caves. It's possible that he helped commit a crime which I'm blamed for. He was the most vicious warrior. We would have been slaughtered were it not for our magic. Even the weakest of my tribe knows simple spells. A gift from sacred glowstone. This glowstone, what is it? As I said, it is a sacred artifact of my tribe. We discovered it in its caverns only short after we fled here. You fled here? Where are you running from? Our old tribe. We were prospering, yet the chieftain insisted on making war against other tribe. The process that we live peacefully, the chieftain disagreed. So I gathered what follows I could and send my tribe. Naturally, my former tribe attempted to hunt us down. It was futile to stand and fight, so Yuan, eventually, we found this place and we have been here ever since. Can I see this glowstone? About the intruder, where is his body now? In ashes, little of him remains. I kept his skull and his weapon. It shames there is no body, but a ring might appear with him. I need that ring, may I have it? My tribe earned this treasure with our blood. If you desire it, you must do the same. What do you need me to do? We share this cavern with a number of giant spiders, if they too possess magic for middle foes. They have recently built a nest of one of the adjoining caves, too close to us by far. Destroy them all and the ring is yours. This has better be worth it. Follow the tunnel to the edge of the domain, you'll find the spiders. Goblin. Hey, what you hear? You turn around, go away. This glowstone cave, our ground is allowed to be in stone. I'm looking for... Wouldn't the stone be safer with your tribe instead of all the way in here? Why do you ask dumb questions? Sacred glowstone light by sacred pool, always been that way. What's so special about the stone? Give us power to make us strong enough to fight enemies like spiders. If we take this stone, we'll be leaving them at the mercy of the spider. It wonders their value is so much. I'm looking for giant spiders. One cave, go back to the way you came. Farewell. heal ourselves.
Bonaparte. Bonaparte.
Okay. Giant spider. An enormous spider emerges from the shadows and scuttles towards you. Its massive abdomen glimmers with pale and sleepy light. Oh. Looks like we made another friend and it's a big one. That spider looks unusually large. It's moving the odd. It looks like it's studying us. Looks like our big friend here is smart enough to figure out a formidable and thinner wolf. It doesn't seem to be attacking, but what I wouldn't give for a huge book to crush this fat right now. As you draw closer, the spider passes around you with a multitude of eyes. What do you want? For a long moment, the spider waves his mandibles as if considering its response. Then it begins to scratch a symbol of Nagon when it follows. The spider is highly intelligent. Why, those glyphs are close enough to be writing, too. My, this is fascinating. The spider completes the first symbol, respect for a moment. I'm not sure what he's trying to say. He may have been an outcast, and it looks angry. But not for us. Spider cracks and mandibles excited and scared. He finds the food, we'll be back. The spider continues to regard you with its many eyes and milk and sodium, but it might not.
It is time everyone march behind me, your new glorious leader.
What do you want?
I think it is time everyone march behind me, your new glorious leader.
I believe so.
Let's take him back to the goblin leader. Can give us the ring. It is done, or your spider all dead? It's not good, so I won't do anymore. Then the scouts have said you have earned the ring, and also got you of my tribe. An excellent other piece of the puzzle. Why, it's just trying. Hardly worth its weight in copper. No, I think it's proved quite valuable. See this in this teeth-like projectants around the edge? This ring is a symbol of the Circle of Blades, a group of murderers native to Luskan. The man of the goblins killed was an assassin very far from home, it seems. I think we should keep searching for more clues, or maybe another item to ever attack us with Sir Haste.
I am listening.
And then gain the level. Let's do a sunbeam. And they just psycho.
Well now, what do you want?
Something about this forest. I can't hear the trees. The voices are strange. There's something wrong with them. It's some kind of poison. Running up along the woods. Feeling odd. Too. A little sluggish. Yes, the poison. It's like brightness seeping from the ground into the branches. We came to the source of this poison and tried to leave this place. That is what I wish for, my wish too. I'm glad we share the same things that my friends gave Eleni. I feel I must warn you, these trees are just good actors, temple to magic energies. My considerable talents may be reduced to a mere. Alright, thanks for the warning. We can adjust our tactics. If it can be sent. Pleasure to help. To be honest, I'm a little giant. It's turning up to be more decent than I hoped. I might even thank Nefal if it keeps up. But enough, let's have this and there's good awaits. Lorne, why haven't you held up your end of the bargain? Yes, Lorne, why haven't you held up your end of the bargain? Answer me. What are you talking about? We never met before. A perfectly good bluff gone to waste. How am I supposed to keep you from the gallows if I have no idea? Oh, I see you're the one disguised as him. Then, trying to prove your innocence, I assume. Yes, I am. How did you disguise Lorne? Alteration powder, a gift from a former guest. It allows you to appear whenever you wish for a time. Lorne and his men stopped nearby before heading to the village. From my trees, I spied on their conversation. The fool is simply going to rush in and kill everyone, and yet someone blame you. I paid an offer to help my mother. You helped him? Why would you do that? Look around you. Can you not see the stumps of dusky trees? The villagers ignored me and harvested the trees again and again, taking far more than necessary. It was an opportunity for vengeance. I offered the disguised Lorne and his men, and they would bring me the glowstone that lies beneath the gate. He agreed, but I was fool to trust him. See if we can get the powder from her. Our story is gathering, but not evidence the powder could be. Do you have more of this powder? Can I have it? And why would you give that? What is it for me? Anything you like. Glowstone is dropped in the water and feels like one of the Lord men is supposed to bring it to me. Lord has failed me, so you will bring the glowstone to me, and I will give you the alteration powder. Let's go get it. It's far trade, so. Once you have the stone, what are you planning to do with it? That's not my concern. Are you going to get me or not? Alright. Stone lies underneath this wood, so seek out the nearby events. Okay.
Let's have a beer!
Yes, 700 experience to the next level. Look, Miri, visitors. What a gnome is doing in Duskwood. Ah, look, not only the woods have an infestation of gnomes, but they seem to have gathered quite an impressive array of insects. What brings you up here? Insect, of course, the shiny, spinny old fly. The yellow-tipped weaver. This good as them abundance and in so many varieties we've never seen before. Collect insect? Just so. We made a study of them. The 20 varieties of horned flies, all manner of waves and grubs. Not only that, we've discovered 4 new aphids. Just here in the Duskwood, there's far more instincts and length than there was. Catch them in the name of the box tidy. Nothing in the business. What up? Do you see what happened to Ember? Ember was one of the human villagers, one who visited the last 10 days. That's so, Miri. And we got all that wonderful mutton, remember? Ember was destroyed, do you know anything about that? Destroyed? No, Marty. Came out of the wood, our work keeps us busy. They used to tell us the lantern that the whole island would sink into the sea before we'd notice. There go Miri and Gina, after the insect again. Think of it, Gina. Ember in ruins. There must be a bad deserve, you understand? Sheep and people both. We should go and pay our respects, don't you think? This place is dangerous. How do you avoid the wolves? Wolves are no trouble, are they, Gila? No trouble. Besides, we're very small and hardly afraid. But we've gone in front of us. You found this cave abandoned? Strange that you should ask. We first met a woman living there. Didn't we, Miri? That's so. She entrusted this place to us, and then she went away. She said that her family had gone or been killed, and she's off to the wild and beat a new clan. That's odd. We have a druid and any chance? I did not think there was anyone talking to Duskwood. Mind if I look around? Rather you didn't, to tell the truth. We like to keep everything just so, our boxes and our samples, and the insects of course. It would be trouble. Yes, Gila, better to be lived in soon. That's good, it's kind to stranger. That's the same, I think I'm going to have a look in the cave.
Time to put these weapons to some use. The land is against you! Nature will have its say.
I concur.
I believe so.
The poor corpse must be part boy. Look, sir, you can tell by the hair. We didn't want you to do it. We never want to. But the blood, the smell, it fills you up. And then it's genuine, so. You killed this man? He came from the hunting ship. And we were here when a cave tapping in a wall in the dark. try to stay away from folk. We truly do. We don't really want to catch them. Little specimen. We gorge on beasts and gods. But when the meat wanders into the lair, then the scout fills up and the blood falling.
I concur.
Well now, what do you want?
I concur.
I believe so.
That's a better armor, okay. Let's level up. What is Hospitaller? A non-gothic base attack is fine, able to get divine spell, diplomacy. Learn hand, nothing special. Sacred Fist. I want to level up the ember, spellcraft, lore, and concentration. Sacred Fist Code of Conduct. Okay, very nice. Very, very nice. Indeed. Let's rest. I think that's enough for now. We'll continue this next time. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And we'll see you next time. Bye bye.